Hello guys, this is Leo the Wise, giving to all men, their needed uprise.
Hi men, hello MGTOWs, welcome to you all. This time sharing some information regarding the importance of the community and as a man going his own way, how this could definitely support your newly discovered reality. Content viewed and taken from the goingyourownway.com website. Let's dive in. Why a MGTOW community matters. Every few months someone recycles the simplistic notion that MGTOWs ought to go their separate ways and not congregate. It stems from a misapprehension of what MGTOW is. There are times when uninformed observers comment on MGTOW in a way that is bereft of judgment. It is typically a glib remark that wholly misunderstands what MGTOW is about. But when it is repeated ad nauseam, I need to say something. In this case, it goes something like, well, I'm fine if people want to be MGTOW, but if they were truly going their own way, why do they need to talk about it all the time online? This observation stems from a total misunderstanding of MGTOW. Here's what is happening. They interpret the acronym literally as men entirely disconnecting from society and other human beings. A very simplistic assessment of what MGTOW is, and one that is fundamentally wrong. MGTOW does not mean living a solitary life in a Unabomber shack. However, MGTOW is not a movement. It's not an organization or a group. So, then what is it? MGTOW as observation, philosophy and life skills. A key reason MGTOWs congregate is to examine the world as it is, women as they are, relationships as they've become. Every day we add to our own awareness of the actuality of women as they are, and the changing nature of relationships. It's done through observation and analysis. We discuss society's bias, approval-seeking behavior by other men, misandrist behavior by corporations, pop culture. A MGTOW community is the antidote to a culture saturated in blue pill BS. MGTOWs are just about the only men who can objectively observe the descent of female behavior, due to feminism, because we're just about the only men who've tamed our sexual instinct. All other men are either too consumed by their sex drive to fault women PUAs, following their sex drive into a bad decision blue pillars, or trying to rationalize the bad decision they already made guy with GF, married man. What our well-meaning but confused observers call complaining is explaining. The culture is the water we swim in. Even if we ignore its dictates, feminist talking points find their way into everything from movie plot lines to signs at work. We observe, critique, and minimize the negative influence of an often ridiculously biased culture against us. MGTOWs are observers of culture, and it's this keenly observant nature that allowed us to see the off-ramp from mainstream idiocy. We continue to keep our eyes open. That's the only way to navigate a world where 90% of the people, men and women around us, are sleepwalking with blue pill feminist programming running through their minds. MGTOW is awareness, leading to a unique lifestyle. It is an awareness that something is very wrong with women today, for reasons we discuss, and that, in response, a man can live a fulfilling life by bucking social norms, defining his sense of self-worth in his own terms, a measure and influence by success with women, and pursuing his life goals and interests fully without the compulsion to spend handfuls of time searching for a soulmate that likely doesn't exist in the age of feminism. It is an awareness of the true nature of women and the changing nature of relationships. From this awareness, a culture or lifestyle develops. That is what we discuss. What shape does the culture take? It varies as widely as the participants, but includes things like, what is an ideal travel destination for a bachelor? Or sharing ideas on male hobbies, or discussing ideal sexual strategy for men in this camp, economizing female options through recreational game. MGTOWs are a unique breed. We are men who are unattached and uninterested in becoming attached. As such, we have unique preferences. We discuss the topics one would if one's life wasn't encumbered by mothers-in-laws or arguing over who drives the kids to daycare, philosophy, books, comedy, movies, filing patents, surf trips, lazy weekends. Unlike married men, we actually get to watch movies we enjoy, Not whichever movie can you can negotiate your wife to also watch. So we go deeper into these areas. To be fair to our critics, much of this living happens offline, something our critics can't see and therefore lazily don't mentally process, and therefore they focus only on the discussions we have online, which they myopically assume is the totality of our existence. To recap, critics mistakenly believe that MGTOW is leaving society and everyone else behind, whereas in reality it is about disregarding society's pressure that a man needs a woman. When we make that singular decision, a different life follows. Though we are all different and take our own path, there is plenty of intersection because we all got off the same off-ramp, and there is much we can share and learn from each other. Living outside the default life script society is set up for people who follow the default life script. That is why there are tons of service providers, travel planning, HR policies for men with families. There are tons of dating adventure travel options for singles. I use singles in terms of men who are unattached but looking to get attached. Bars for single people to meet up, dating sites, magazines for young men who are interested in overpaying for the right sunglasses that women are into. When you ignore this life script, you necessarily live an alternative lifestyle, and that requires discussion in order to best navigate it, because there aren't well-worn contours. We are building that lifestyle and culture through our investigations and then sharing it with the wider community. For lurkers, here's my cartoon drawing example if it's not clear by now. Let's say you broke with a social norm. Let's say you decided to only eat breakfast every meal of the day. Society is set up to serve steak and sushi for dinner, not omelets. But if you felt there was nothing amish about bacon and waffles, and it was fitting any minute of the day, you may want to share tips with other breakfast addicts as to which restaurants actually have breakfast options at 9 p.m. What places have the best syrup, etc. You would have to talk about it because the standard mainstream restaurant review sites like Yelp largely wouldn't. There are those who don't want MGTOWs to congregate because they don't like what we have to say. It's too painful to hear. There are others who suffered from simple-mindedness and assume the only organizing principle for men is political. But MGTOWs will continue to enjoy one another's camaraderie, share theories and advice, and examine life as a man in our times.
And that is it for now. If this content was entertaining and interested you, please share, like, and subscribe to this channel. I am the Swan, leading men till dawn, and even beyond. Thanks for the audience.